सबसे ज्यादा पढ़ाई चाहता।
स्कूल कैसे जाती हो तुम सुबह में?
दीदी छोड़ने जाती है।
मैं कहीं चली जाऊंगी तो ये रोने लगती है, ये चली जाती तो मुझे अच्छा नहीं लगता, मन नहीं लगता घर पे।
हम बच्चे अपने लिए कुछ नहीं चाहते, अपने लिए ना चाहते, बाकी बच्चे के लिए हम इतना चाहते कि बाल बच्चे हमारा अच्छा से रहे।
दस नहीं करता, थक जाता, पैर में दर्द रहता।
मेरा काम है सुबह अपना कटिंग करना, कपड़े को काटना, फिर उसे अपने उसी कटिंग को बनाना, फिर शाम को अपना तैयार करना, प्रेस व्रेस मार के रख देना, मैं टांग देता हूँ। ग्राहक आते हैं अपना ले जाते हैं, पैसे दे जाते हैं।
Your father loves you very much, right?
सूट की बनाऊँ, जेंसी बनाऊँ, लेड़ से बनाऊँ और सबके बनाता हूँ, घोड़ा बिल्ली कुत्ता बंदर सबके बना देता हूँ।
मैं पहले तो मेरे दर्द हुआ था यहाँ पे पेट में, पसली से नीचे, सफदरजन से मेरे मुझे बताया गया कि टीबी है।
तुम्हें पता है कि तुम बीमार हो? तुम्हें कुछ बीमारी है तुम्हें मालूम है? हाँ हाँ
This could be a real disaster in public health. So it's everyone's business to understand and combat tuberculosis.
There are basically two types of tuberculosis. One is pulmonary tuberculosis, TB of the lungs, and the other is extrapulmonary, which can affect any part of the body. When tuberculosis affects the lungs, then every breath you take, every time you exhale, you are bringing out tuberculosis bacteria.
TB is caused by bacteria. It's an infection. As we know that any patient who does not take treatment, he can infect 10 to 15 people with TB. So this leads to continuous transmission.
The single biggest risk factor to contracting tuberculosis is breathing in. Wherever people travel and wherever they cough, they're going to give it to other people. Countries with great migration or transit of populations, say the UK for a classic example, you will find a greater proportion of tuberculosis happening. So also in border regions of the United States. Of the 9 to 10 million people that contract tuberculosis annually every year around the globe, about 2 million happen in India. Of these, a quarter million or so die. India contributes quite a significant proportion. We can and we do have the resources today to diagnose tuberculosis fairly early enough, and it's a very treatable condition.
It's simply a bacterial infection. It can be cured fully, and no one need to suffer or die of TB, and no one need to infect others.
Operation ASHA is running a fantastic program where health workers deliver medication to patients. But the tragedy and the threat in India is that that delivery breaks down because they're running a very large geographically distributed system where you have lots of medication in very remote places being delivered to patients. So if patients, for various reasons, fall off the course of medication and don't finish the full 6-month course of antibiotics, and that's when you get drug-resistant tuberculosis.
For somebody who is poor, drug-resistant tuberculosis definitely becomes a death sentence.
It's extremely expensive and difficult to treat. And this represents the threat of really a pandemic, because drug-resistant TB is also contagious. And so if this strain of TB actually spreads, it represents a threat to everyone.
अब एकरा आगे तो हम और कुछ नहीं बता सकते, यही आपको सुना दिए। परेशानी बहुत है, अब क्या करें, आप ही सह है। उम्मीद तो रखते हैं कि सही होगा कि नहीं होगा, यही दिमाग में।
Manisha came to Operation Asha 2 years ago, and at that time she had developed lymph nodes. So we sent her to the public hospital taking care of this particular area, and she was diagnosed as a case of extrapulmonary tuberculosis.
यही
विश्वास है कि आप लोग आते हैं तो बच्चे के लिए कि बच्चा के हमारा सही हो जाएगा और तो हमारा कोई ना हमारा है दुनिया में.
For 9 months she has been on treatment for the lymph nodes. That wound has not healed in spite of treatment. So what is wrong? My guess is that Manisha has got drug resistant TB. Giri Prasad was diagnosed as a case of pulmonary tuberculosis. He had bacteria in the breath. So he had to take all precautions so that he doesn't infect his own family members.
सबसे बड़ा परहेज करता हूँ कि बच्चों से दूर रहने की कोशिश करता हूँ, कोई मतलब जो दूसरे को ना हो जाए, सोना बैठना दूसरी जगह. अब यह है कि सोच रहे हैं कि ठीक हो जाएंगे तब बिता लेंगे, ठीक होने का इंतजार है, उसके बाद में देख लेंगे खेलना कूदना.
So I work in a group called Technologies for Emerging Markets at Microsoft Research India, and we look at kind of the role of technology in low-income communities in India and around the world. So sometimes that means inventing a new technology, sometimes it means taking an existing technology off the shelf and applying it in a novel way that has a bigger impact for communities that are in need. So we talked in detail with Operation Asha, our field partner, about understanding what are the challenges in delivering healthcare to kind of the most inaccessible communities. When you're walking to the clinic, you know, it's a very lively place. There's lots of energy and very vibrant, except it's very challenging as well. Various livestock wandering through the streets. You know, it's a small and cramped environment. Can barely fit, you know, 6 or 7 people. It's hot. There's no running water. Lots of background noise. And that's also the place where technology has to work.
The biggest challenge in TB treatment is that it's a long duration of treatment, and when patients default and miss their medication, they develop drug resistance.
And our solution is a simple terminal that uses a biometric fingerprinting scanner to actually take the identification of patients and health workers every time a dose of medication is delivered. And those logs are stored in the terminal and uploaded via a cell phone, via SMS messaging, so people in the office can see exactly where the medication is going and follow up in the case of any challenges.
It is ensured that patient has visited TB clinic, and we can suppose that patient was given supervised medicine.
You know, this is an example where Microsoft Research is extending the state of the art to combine technologies that have never been combined in this way.
This is a Hindu temple. The centers exist in shops, in temples, and nobody would know that TB treatment is going on from a temple. Nobody would even think of it, because a patient would not like to go to a place that says, here tuberculosis treatment is going on. But the importance of technology is that it ensures every dose taken, it prevents fudging of data, it ensures accuracy of records, it ensures that our counselors are coming on time, going on time. Treatment has to be simple, effective, inexpensive, and convenient for the patient, especially when we are dealing with something as challenging as tuberculosis.
आ जाओ भोले बाबा.
It's important to extend healthcare right to the doorsteps of the most inaccessible patients. You know, they're working very long hours, they're constrained with housework, and so they don't have time to travel a long distance to a hospital or to big public health centers that are often located in wealthy neighborhoods and other locations. So in our research group, we spend a lot of time thinking about how to design computer interfaces for novice or low literate users, you need to have lots of graphics in your interface, audio cues, multilingual content. And so that's a really important thing to design for as well, not just a user, but the whole environment where the technology lives. We're active in 28 centers now. About 13 health workers are working with the technology. And we've logged over 2,500 patients and monitored 50,000 doses. So this isn't a project where we aspire to scale up the solution ourselves. We think if we demonstrate rigorous impact, other people will also adopt it. And that's what we're seeing already across multiple continents with this technology.
We plan to implement Microsoft technology using biometric terminals in our forthcoming project, which will be implemented through Operation ASHA, and we'll be focusing on mines where migrant laborers, they are predisposed for tuberculosis infection.
Very soon we'll be working in Uganda with another nonprofit. We will be implementing the same biometrics in their TB treatment centers and providing technology. Patients who come to a temple to pray, they don't just pray for themselves or their families. They also pray for a cure.
देखिए मैम हम भगवान पर भरोसा रखते हैं एकदम ये ना कहते हैं कि उतना उसको हो गया उतना हमारा हो जाए वो नहीं हमारा जो लिखल है वही होता है भगवान पर भरोसा जो करेंगे सो भगवान करेंगे इतना विश्वास है कि सही हो
जाएगा खुशी तो होती है खैर इस चीज़ के बारे में तो खुशी होती है कि मेरा साथ में सारा परिवार साथ दे रहा है पर यह है कि ऐसी बीमारी किसी को ना लगे तो बेहतर है
जीवन मांगेंगे अपने जिंदगी जिंदगी क्या हमारी जिंदगी ना रहे
अब मेरी मदद पापा ना करते तो मैं कैसे जीता वैसे ही है एक दूसरे की मदद जरूरी है उसी को परिवार कहते हैं
मैं अपने क्या करूँ मेरे तो सब चीज़ें मुझे कुछ भी नहीं करना है
कुछ तो होता होगा ना सबके मन में कुछ ना कुछ होता है तुम्हारे मन में क्या
मैं ये भी कहती हूँ मेरी बहन अच्छी हो जाए
People in the world are infected by the bacteria causing multi-drug resistant TB. Unbelievable but true. But I know and I believe we can prevent drug resistant TB with the help of technology and community empowerment.
It's really about the people at the end of the day. If you connect to that level and understand what are the human steps that it takes to overcome those challenges, I think that's really kind of the place to start.
Action. Madhubala.